Hey there, welcome back to the workshop. What you have in front of you is, of course, another creepy cool figure kit. You know I love figure kits. I get really excited about them, and this brand new one from AMT had me pumped from the minute I heard it was coming out. Well, now I've got one, and I can show you what's in it and show you just how cool it is. This is the AMT Dirty Donnie's Pinball Punk resin model kit. Being resin, it won't go together with regular model cement. You'll have to use CA glue or epoxy, which is just fine. You can get it anywhere, but I wanted to let you know that so that you don't try putting your favorite tester's cement on there or your Plastruct bonding on there. Like I always show you, it's not going to hold the kit together. You're going to have to use regular style adhesives, 5-minute epoxy, or a similar adhesive like CA glue, super glue. Those will all work. It's over 8 inches tall. He's a big size figure. So let's start taking a look at everything that's going to be in the box when you get yours. It is a very simple assembly. It is not very parts intensive, so it's going to go together quite well like most figure kits, but this one is a little cooler than your average figure kit. So let's start taking a look at all the parts. We're going to get the Pinball Punk in his entirety out here on the screen, because he is pretty sweet. So there he is. He's a big boy. You can see the large resin slugs go together just like so. He is a nice big dude. Each one of those squares is 8 inches. So you can measure that, or each one of those squares is 1 inch. He's just over 8 inches tall, totally assembled. Look at the detail on that double face. He's got them creepy rock biting teeth. Looks like he works in a quarry chewing off granite chunks all day, and it goes all the way around. He's got 4 sets of eyes, but fear not. They've got molded in pupils. Doing the eyes on this guy will be super, super easy. He's got 2 types of hat. See the detail they can get in a big piece of resin like that? And another thing, no pinholes. The castings are smooth. A lot of times in a resin kit, you're going to have all kinds of issues, but not with this. This one actually is really smooth. It's really well done. It's got nice big locating pins. You can get all that work done on there super easy. His feetses are down here. Check out those shoes on his big feet. The laces. Look at that gross belly button. Ew. A detailer's dream. Check out those shorts, the pockets, his posterior, the back of the shoes. Those are some sweet Converse he's got on there. You'd pay top dollar for those nowadays with the laces and everything. And it's such a nice big size that it's going to be really easy to paint. He's got 4 arms because, well, he's got 2 heads. 2 that are going to be playing the pinball machine, and 2 that are going to be doing other things for him, keeping him busy. You can see the detail on the fingernails. What's cool about a monster kit like this is you kind of have your own license on how you want to paint it. You don't have to worry about skin shades. You don't have to worry about any of that. You just do it up just the way you want, and that's how it's going to be. We got great detail on those fingers. Even the nails stick out. Excellent molding on this AMT. Just superb. This finger here. This one kind of hangs up and holds on to an accessory I'm going to show you. And then we've got, of course, he's playing pinball. He's at the arcade. He's going to have a big piece of za. And there's plenty of room to get my entire finger fits in here. So there's plenty of room to get a paintbrush in here and get this painted out. And again, even though a detailed piece like this, no pinholes, no weird warps, no nothing like that. Just great detail all the way around. So let's get the figure out of the way. We'll show you the other parts in the kit. Move those over. Now we got the sweet pinball machine. Even if you didn't want to build a figure, this giant pinball machine is worth it all by itself, because you've got so much cool stuff going on here. You've got the coin. You can see it's a Dirty Donnie coin. And on the back, it's got AMT. See if you can focus on that white resin. Then we've got this die here. The die is for the ball shooter. And that's actually going to fit right there on the machine when you start building it. And then we've got this cool trick-or-treat basket made of a skull, and the wire is included and is assembled when you get it out of the box. Nice big piece of resin there. That's going to hang from that upswung finger that I showed you. So that's going to go like that, all kinds of detail. Now, here's the pinball machine. It's got everything molded together. Even the legs are molded on it, which I was surprised. But there are. They're just built right onto it. So that's really cool. We've got the flipper buttons. We've got the interior of the machine. We've got the back, so it looks just like a regular pinball machine from the 70s. And then we've got the back of the machine, the scorekeeper, the decorator, the noisemaker, and that goes together like so. Just fits together, looks awesome, matches Donnie in size. Now, we also have in there, to make a lot of your painting nightmares go away, a huge decal sheet for the Punk and the pinball machine. You can see we've got the pinball play area, we've got the backboard, we've got all different kinds of graffiti for it, we've got the painting on the sides of the machine, those nice stripes, and then we've got, you know, the token, the pinball club, multi-ball, pinhead, all those kind of cool extra decals on there. And then we've got the pinball punk decals as well. An enormous decal sheet, standard paper size, it's huge. Should go on real nice, and the color register on there is just beautiful. So what am I going to do? Right now I'm going to take the figure and I'm going to tack them together. I'm not going to glue them together all the way, but I'm going to tack them together and set them with the pinball machine so you can see what you're going to get when you get this kit, so you know exactly what it'll look like before you start painting. I'll be right back. Welcome back to the review. He looks really cool, doesn't he? Now I've just got the arms barely tacked in with some blue tack. Anything that after you glue, it's going to need a very little bit of filler, and I'm talking, you know, as you can see, the very small gaps in here, we're talking maybe 30 minutes of gap filling and sanding. That's it. This would be a good beginner kit to get into resins. You can see the cool die on there. Of course, it hasn't been attached and held in place, but it'll sit straight up once you glue it on. I even managed to get the coin to fit in his fingers without gluing it. You can see that he's getting ready to drop that in the cool machine. Now, this would be all painted up and detailed. You can see he's got the pizza going into his maw. His hand actually grips the other side of the machine to press the button. He's getting ready to drop his coin, play a cool game. He's got the little jack-o'-lantern there, skull hanging from there. And you can see he's already to play the game. Now, there's my big hand, and he's as big as that. He's a nice size figure, over 8 inches tall. I think it looks really cool. I wanted to get them all together so you guys could see what it looked like before painting. This is going on the short list, and I'm going to get this one. I'm going to start working on it pretty soon, and you're going to be able to see it when it's all done another day. Thanks for watching this review of AMT's brand new resin monster model kit, Dirty Donnie's Pinball Punk. We'll see you at the next review.